that's good.
So, in October, I plan on going to California for All-Star Bash, and, you know, I'm obviously taking the Suburban and the drift truck and the trailer and all that, and there's stuff I need to do to the Suburban before I can go to California, and stuff I'd like to do and change and things like that. Like, I'd really like to just buy a new truck, but I'm probably not going to do that, so I'm going to, you know, fix up the Suburban and do it the way I want to do it. So today, I'm going to go buy a parts truck in Nebraska. I'm waiting for Mike to show up because he's going to be my co-pilot today. So it's another big block, 3/4 ton, but it's a Silverado with a manual trans. So I'd love to put a manual trans in the Suburban. And looking around at what's available out here, it looked like it was just going to be cheaper and more efficient to buy an entire parts truck because, you know, I need to change the steering column because the Suburban has the column shift and get all the, you know, the column covers, the shift boot, clutch pedal, master cylinder, slave cylinder, bell housing, drive shafts, transfer case, all that stuff is going to be changed. And it's also got some other stuff that I need to, like side view mirrors, tail lights. It's got a bench seat that I really want to that I want to put in the Suburban. I'd like to have a bench seat because Cato likes to sit up front between me and Elizabeth on the center console, and I just kind of like it's not a good spot for him to sit. Headlights I need, just all kinds of knickknack shit. So it just makes more sense for me to go buy an entire parts truck, and it's at a cheap enough price to where I'm like, yeah, hell yeah, let's go get that thing now. So I need to start thinking about my plan of attack for that because, you know, October's coming up pretty quick here and I don't want to get into a situation where it's a week before I got to leave for All-Star Bash and the fucking Suburban doesn't even have a transmission in it because, that's just how I seem to do things. But yeah, just waiting for Mike to show up and then we're gonna go on an adventure and go pick up a donor. That's the thing. Made it all the way back. That brush guard's kind of growing on me. Thinking about maybe snagging that for the Suburban too. But this truck used to be an iron and metal truck. I don't know if you guys can see the old sticker on the door there. So it used to be a steel yard truck. And then it was a farm truck. So this thing's been through hell and back. But it's got all the stuff that I need. It's got manual trans, it's a 4x4, it's got a bench seat that I kind of want, mirrors, headlights, taillights, all that fun stuff. It runs and drives pretty good. The distributor, I guess, is off like one tooth because he said he replaced the distributor and he couldn't get it timed right, so it's kind of like a little boggy, but I mean, it's got like 300,000 miles on it, so I'm not really taking like the engine or anything, so that's fine. Everything else that drivetrain wise seemed good, like the diffs aren't leaking, the front CVs look good, like, so it might have been, you know, well taken care of, but the whole underside of that truck's got like a 1-inch layer of fucking mud. It's pretty ridiculous, so I'm gonna pressure wash that before I get to work on it. I got 2 months roughly until All-Star Bash, so sooner or later I got to get into stripping that thing and taking the shit that I need, and then this truck is all done, just finished detailing it, finished all the paintless dent removal, replaced the hood, repaired the roof rails on both sides, had to get it painted, just put it all back together. The right side roof rail molding is on back order. I ordered it like 2.5 weeks ago, but it should be coming in this afternoon, and Billy's dad's gonna come pick this thing up. Gave the shop a quick little cleanup, and then these showed up. These big motherfuckers right here. So this is a 19 by 13. I'm gonna guess a negative 20. I don't know the exact size. And the fronts are 19 by 10s. Zero, I wanna say. And then kinda just test fitted one of those rears on, and it pokes out a shitload. So I have the over fenders for this up there. I'm gonna have to do kinda what I did on Colin's car, that that coupe that I was working on that had those big baller gold wheels on it. So I'm gonna put those over fenders on, and I'm gonna have to like bow them to get it to bow it to like, I don't know, 150 mil. And then I'm probably gonna have to put a little bit of camber in it. Tires are gonna be exorbitantly expensive. I think I was looking at like Nitto NT 555s were like $280 a piece, and that was like the most reasonable tire I could find that would fit those rears. It's like a 315, 35, 19. Pretty insane. But yeah, so waiting for the owner to come get that. The guy with the Ferrari is going to be bringing his car by at like 6:30, and then I got to go pick up Elizabeth's mom from the airport. But I'm going to try and buy some equipment. I need a bandsaw really, really badly. So I'm going to try and find a bandsaw this week and prep for round three of competition, which is this upcoming weekend. The drift truck doesn't need a whole lot. I ordered tires. I need to make an intake mount, maybe try and paint some stuff, but I doubt I'll get to it this week. But basically, yeah, just kind of mellow out this week and get back to a regular schedule, do some work on the hot rod and get the drift truck ready. So yeah, it's going to be a good week. Bow chicka wow wow. He put his ADV1 wheels on, came back to install some new emblems. I don't know where he put them, but the emblems he got, they're like aftermarket and they don't have mounting studs, so I can't like tighten them down the way they're supposed to be, so he's gonna have to get some factory emblems for it. But car looks damn good with these wheels on it. Love this fucking thing. Alright people, so I'm pretty excited right now. I just found a really good bandsaw on Craigslist. It's made by Wilton. They also make like really, really, really good vices. I need to get a Wilton vise, but I like their equipment. I found one locally. It's like a 14-inch bandsaw. Might even be a little bit bigger than that, but it looks like it's brand new and it's like pretty, pretty cheap. It's reasonable. So I'm going to go jump on that because all the other bandsaws I've been looking at, like the day they're posted, they're gone. I don't know, like, bandsaws I guess are super popular right now, so I'm not gonna sleep on this one. I'm gonna go hop in a Suburban and go hopefully pick this thing up right now and have a new piece of equipment that I've been needing forever. So yeah, super excited. So I went and got the new blades for this thing today. It's called a 1014 blade. I don't know what the hell it means. No, I'm kidding. It's like a mixture or like a staggered set of 10 TPI and 14 TPI teeth per inch. So it kind of like alternates, and it's good for like stainless and thin stuff. So that's what I liked to use at my last job. So I got the same blades for this, and I like using the thin blades because it's more like agile. You can do like tight radius cuts and stuff like that. So yeah, I was cutting some stuff with it earlier, and it kicks ass. I had to change the speeds on it because that thing was spinning at like 3,300 RPM, or not RPM, but like, I forget how those things are measured, like feet per second or inches per second or something like that. So I slowed it down to what it says on the chart would be like 270, and it seems to cut really well. So what I'm working on now, Mike dropped off these bumpers for his car. They're Joe's Aero Kit for the X8 Cressida. And he wants me to make some bash bars for him. He already, I've had the material here leaning up against the wall forever. And he paid me to actually like make the bash bars for it a couple weeks ago. So finally getting around to it. So what I did was I laid the bumper on the floor, and I outlined the bumper, and then figured out like how I wanted the bash bar to be shaped. Like originally for the front, I was thinking of doing like one bend in the middle, but then I was like, nah, I'm gonna do four bends so it fits nice and tight. And then I just mapped it all out, bend start points, and measured the degrees and so on and so forth, and went and bent it up. And then same thing for the rear, laid the rear bumper on the ground, measured it out. The rear isn't as critical, and the rear bumper was actually a lot flatter than the front, so I did just do one bend in the center for that. So I'm going to get a little further along on these tomorrow. Since I don't have the car here, I'm just going to try and basically build the structure inside the bumper and get the bumper skins mounted to the bash bar, so then that way when Mike shows up with the car on Friday, we could basically just hold the bumper up or like set the bumper up on the car where it needs to be and then build the mounts to like the frame rails and stuff like that. That's the plan anyways. So and Mike knows how to weld and he wants to get more comfortable with TIG welding, so I think I'm just gonna like prep everything and tack it for him and have it ready for him to weld, and I'll kind of like give him some pointers and stuff like that so I can keep working on some other shit. So, just finished building the structures for Mike's bash bars. So I got the two tiers, the upper and the lower, and the tie-ins, and the Zeus tabs on both sides. And used the smaller Zeus tabs. I didn't want to use the big, bulky ones. And then those were the only ones that had a far enough reach. So then on the rear, I also built him a little jacking point too, and it wraps around. I only did a single tier in the rear, and then two Zeus tabs on the top, and the shop is a fucking mess. So we got Mike's front bash bar on. It's in there, tucked up all nice and tight. Made these brackets that bolt onto the end of the frame rail. I just didn't have the right size bolt to go in that hole there, but yeah, so front bash bar is all welded up and bolted on the car, and put the bumper on and Zeused it on, and just zip tied the corners to the fender so the fender isn't all like floppy dongers on there. And Mike just put on his side skirts, and car's looking cool. I was joking around that I haven't seen this car with a front bumper ever, and I've known Mike for a year and a half now. Yeah, 2 years, something like that. And
ever since I had the car, it lasted about 3 months. I was like, big wheels, can't fit the bumper.
Yep.
Never had it on.
Yep. Yeah, now it's looking pimp proper. I like it.
Pimp proper.
Pimp proper. Just needs paint. Well, and we got to do the rear. I don't have time today because today I got to prep for round three, which is tomorrow, and I got to wake up at like 6 a.m. tomorrow, so I got to like try and get as much shit done as I can and get everything ready to rock. So yeah, Mike's gonna come back sometime next week and we'll finish that up. But yeah, I gotta do a little bit of stuff with the drift truck. I kinked the throttle cable really badly, so I had to go to the junkyard and get another throttle cable. If you guys ever need like a really 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 long throttle cable, an Infiniti G20 has got like the longest throttle cable I've ever seen. So just a little tip for you guys. Oh, also gotta change the spark plugs, because I've never changed the spark plugs in that truck since I built that engine. So gonna do more things. So a handsome Billy showed up, and now we're hanging out.
I don't see him.
So we're on our way over to After Hours Drift Shop. Just loaded up all of my tires and wheels and stuff, and took Elizabeth's wheels too. Gonna get her tires dismounted so we can sandblast her rims and then paint them the same color as her cage. But yeah, there's a lot of shit back there. See if Justin will let us film inside of a shop. I'm sure he's got some cool shit going on. So next stop, After Hours Drift Shop.
Or not.
So this is Justin's shop, After Hours Drift Shop. It's like seriously a couple minutes from mine and Billy's shop. He just picked up this RX-7, pretty rowdy little car. He's going to be sliding this on Sunday, right? You're going to be sliding this on Sunday?
Yeah.
That was a Z46 that unfortunately met with a cinder block wall at round two. Kind of a freak accident sort of thing, but it's cool. He's got another car lined up, ready for him to rip. And I just found out recently that he has a tire machine and balancer, so I'm like, hey man, you want to do all my fucking tires for me? And he's like, yeah. So brought him, you know, all my shit. So Justin's a cool dude. Met him at round one and chatted it up for a minute. And it's cool that he's in our neck of the woods. But yeah, his shop's pretty sick. I like his floors a lot. I want these floors. Yeah, if you're in Golden, Lakewood, Wheat Ridge, whatever area, check these guys out.